Everybody, CW here, Card Wolf, because I am always on the hunt for junk. I'm not sure. I'm out here starting the show in my garage today, which, as you can see, has been taken over by the various family members who've been bringing over their stuff for the yard sale all week. The yard sale is tomorrow morning, so they have been at it for most of the day, pricing things and unpacking the boxes and getting stuff ready on tables to take out there, and it's quite an array of stuff, I will tell you that much. You can see there's a sort of an old-fashioned baby carrier over there with a dolphin in it. That is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to some of the weird stuff that is going to be for sale tomorrow. And I've been out here helping them organize stuff. That big orangish red rusty colored thing in the middle there is actually a beanbag chair. It was custom made for one of my wife's uncles, and he is letting that go because he doesn't use it anymore. And I sat in it, and they had to wheel a crane in here to get me out of it because it sinks down pretty well. See a lot of tools here that we're going to be selling. There's also quite a lot of kitchen stuff and even some clothes. There's a nice lamp over there. Let me see if I can get that. You can see that green lamp. I've got one just like that on my desk, and I thought about grabbing that one as a backup, but I think I'm just going to let it go into the sale. There's some golf clubs around here, some furniture, as you can see, and right at my feet here are some record albums. I actually went through this when it was first dropped off in the garage because I do collect record albums, and I think everything that's left in here is not stuff that I am necessarily that into. A lot of Tom Jones and CCR in here, Smokey Robinson, a lot of Hawaiian music, which I'm not sure where that came from, some Elvis albums, which I do not like Elvis, ABBA, you guys know how I feel about that, who doesn't like ABBA, this Depeche Mode album I actually already had, and I was surprised to see it in here. I didn't think any of my family was into Depeche Mode. Maybe that was one of mine that I had doubles of or something and was in another box I wasn't aware of. Led Zeppelin. I like Led Zeppelin, but that live album's not a very good one. So you can kind of see what is left in here. If you see something you're especially excited about, let me know in the comments and I will remove it before tomorrow morning when it goes on the driveway for people to paw through and buy for themselves. Village people, I know you guys are going to be excited about that. So yeah, that's what's left after I got through with it. You can imagine. So I just thought I'd give you a peek. There's a nice rug there, actually. That's a pretty nice rug, but we have no place for that. Just thought I'd give you sort of a glimpse at some of the chaos going on out in the garage and what I've been preoccupied with for the last couple of days when I haven't been lying in bed with a headache, which revisited me last night, but I did get rid of it. It's now in the 40s out here, the low 40s at that, and we've got about a 10 or 15 mile an hour wind coming off the mountains, so it's very chilly today. Tomorrow it's supposed to be a little warmer, but I may need to break back out the winter coats in order to have the yard sale tomorrow. I'm going to go back inside where it's warmer and start the show properly. I'll see you in just a moment. All right, here we are back inside. It's a lot warmer in here, much nicer. It is quite chilly out in that garage today, I'll tell you that much. Today, as you can probably already tell, we're doing a little bit of the Card Wolf Variety Show, which I enjoy myself, and I kind of warned you guys I'd get back to this format at some point. So here we are again with the Variety Show. Yesterday on the channel, if you were here, you saw that I got some bonus cards in the big lot of 1973 Tops that I opened. The seller was kind enough to send me a bunch of these Donruss All-Stars pop-up puzzle and cards. I'd never seen these before, and I was pretty excited. Yesterday we opened one of those packs just to see what they were like, and it had this sort of interesting pop-up thing that you assembled, and this one was Terry Kennedy of the Orioles, and I thought that was kind of interesting. It got me thinking about some other pop-ups. This was also in there. This is from Kraft Singles, so I assume this came with like cheese or something. I don't remember these at all, but you pull this and you can see in this case Cecil Fielder pops right up and you can see his statistics there, and you get to see sort of a 3D effect there if you sit the card down on the table, so that's kind of neat too, and seeing those kind of got me thinking about other pop-ups that I am aware of. And actually this is I was surprised that I could think of the ones that I didn't actually have some in my collection. I have some of these post NHL Stars in Action pop-ups. These were issued only in Canada, I believe, and I don't have the whole set, but I do have some. And these, I'll show you one of these. This one was already open, and you can see this is Stan Smile with the Canucks, and you can see he kind of. You know, you got two levels here, the background with a shot from the game and then sort of a picture of the player in isolation there, sort of standing in front of it. And then you got these statistics down here from the entire team. So this set came out, there was one player per team. Unfortunately, I don't have the Oilers, which I think featured Gretzky, as I recall. But I do have several of the other ones, and they're kind of neat. They're very unusual. These came out, as you can see, in 81, 82. And as I said, they were released only in Canada, as far as I know. So those were some that came to mind. Most of the pop-ups that I have ever seen, and I don't have a lot of these. These were just the ones that I could find when I kind of was mentally thinking about it, and then you know what I could locate in my collection. Most of the ones that I've ever seen are from non-sport issues, and this is an example of that. Batman the Animated Series put out cards. I guess it was in the 90s, the mid-90s or so, and you know, these are pop-ups too. I'll just show you this one. You can see it kind of folds this way, and you've got the figure in there, and then whoops, you push it down, and then the character pops up out of there, and then it kind of sits like that on a base, and you can kind of, you know, move that around. It's two-sided, so you know, you can see this more up close if you want to. I'll bring it up to the camera, see if I like to focus today. They're kind of neat. I mean, it's a neat idea. It's interesting that card manufacturers kind of came up with you know, the templates, I guess, to sort of make this. Wow, the camera really did. There we go. Thanks, camera. That's really, it's your job is to focus on things, and you seem to vex me at every turn. But it's kind of neat that I think the card manufacturers have kind of come up with different ways to sort of construct these. I mentioned yesterday that I also knew that there were Star Trek cards that did this. I couldn't find any of those because I have a lot of different boxes that are just labeled Star Trek, which is, in my world, not particularly helpful. I need to label things more specifically because I have a lot of different kinds of Star Trek cards, and so that didn't really help me to get anywhere in terms of finding those. But then I thought, you know, this isn't new technology. Now you look at these and you think, well, this, you know, this kind of die cut stuff and, you know, having perforations and folds and things, that must be, you know, something that they've only been doing for the last 20 or 30 years. But in fact, they've been doing it for a very long time. As some of you know, I also collect old timey tobacco cards, and I dug out one of those that I could show you. This one's pretty beat up. This is, I'll get the camera to focus on this for you too, if it would like to behave itself today, which it doesn't want to for some reason. What is going on? There we go. So anyway, this is from Ogden's Children of All Nations set, which came out in the 20s. I think this is from 1924, if I remember right. And it just featured kids from all over the world in sort of what was thought of as sort of their native garb at that time. And, you know, some of the art for these cards is actually pretty nice, and then some of it is pretty creepy. And I think this one is from Egypt, and it's a little bit creepy for me. But anyway, this one's pretty marked up. It has crayon on it, and it's got some creases and whatnot. So I can show you how this works. It's perforated, and there you can kind of see how that goes. And then the actual character, the figure of the child, sits up. It's perforated right here, and she would sit all the way up like that. And you could kind of sit that on your desk and gaze fondly at the little cherub from Egypt if that's what you wanted to do. And you can see on the back, you know, it gives you this helpful push here sort of thing. But anyway, I'm just showing you that to let you know that this technology or this the ability to do this has in fact been present in trading cards for quite a long time. And the idea of having sort of a 3D thing happen with a flat two-dimensional card is one that has sort of captured the attention of card manufacturers for a very long time. So anyway, there are a lot of other cards that pop up in this way or pop up in different ways. And I'm sure that somebody like maybe Criterium Racer or Zach's collection. Zach, you probably know more about this than I do. You guys both collect a lot of non-sports stuff, a lot of different variety of stuff. So you probably have better examples or more examples of this than I had on hand, just kind of thinking off the top of my head about this. So anyway, I do all of that as sort of a precursor to opening some more of these pop-up packs because I'm very kind of interested in this. I really do not remember these cards from the 80s. This is from I think we decided this is from 88 because it commemorates the 87 All-Star teams from both sides of the American League and the National League. So I'm gonna open a couple more of these packs today, and then I got another thing to open right after that as part of the variety hour. So let's go ahead and see who we get here, who our pop-up card is. We got the puzzle piece card, of course, and that is a Stan Musial puzzle. And our pop-up card in this pack is of Dave Winfield from the Yankees. Let me bring this closer. There we go. Dave Winfield of the Yankees. And that one looks pretty neat too. Like the Terry Kennedy card, he is also batting, and you can easily see how that would perforate around there and pop up. So he was the starter in right field, apparently, for the 87 All-Star game. So that's pretty neat. I'll put that right there. And then there's Davey Johnson, the manager for the National League with the Mets, former second baseman for the Orioles. And Mark McGwire, 1988. That's a fairly early Mark McGwire card. Rick Sutcliffe and Brett Saberhagen for the American League. And Willie McGee, good outfielder for the Cardinals for many years, was also a member of the All-Star team. And let's see who's in the second pack. See what we get here. I did not look at a checklist for this set. I looked online to see if these were particularly valuable because I didn't want to be ripping open a whole lot of packs if these were expensive or super rare or anything. Since I didn't know about them, I thought, well, maybe these were just produced in very limited numbers or something like that, but that wasn't the case. These are not overly expensive or anything. So all right, Gary Carter, that's a nice one. Gary Carter card there. Very nice card. And he was the catcher for the National League, of course. I'll put him right there. Looks like, I wonder if all of these are of players batting, or if, I assume if we got a pitcher, it would show the pitcher in his windup or something like that. And I assume they did not make manager pop-up cards, but maybe they did. I don't know what the manager would be doing. In the old days, they would always have, in the 60s, I feel like they had a lot of cards of the managers holding their, cupping their hand up to their mouth as though they're yelling something across the field to someone. That seemed to be the managerial pose back in those days. So maybe they'd be doing that on these in-action cards. That would be pretty interesting. Mike Witt, and for those of you who didn't see yesterday's episode, though the fronts of these cards look very similar to the Donruss 88 release, the back of these cards, they're all completely different from what the backs of the regular 1988 cards look like. And I think these images are different too. We got a Willie McGee duplicate there. You wouldn't think that would happen, but I think the checklist must be very small for this. There's Tom Henke, Blue Jays card, for those of you who are into the Jays. Tony Gwynn, that's a nice one. I will PC that one, go ahead and put that one in the Wolf Lair. And Pat Tabler apparently was the starting first baseman for the American League. That is a surprise to me. Not that Tabler was a bad first baseman by any means, but there were a lot of good first basemen playing in the American League in 1988. So, I mean, Tabler must have had some kind of sensational first half of the year that year for some reason. It was the first time that he was named to the All-Star team. And he had a career-high 326 in 1986. So he had a couple of good years there. I do not remember that, but I was also not really tracking the Indians much then other than that they were an opponent of the Orioles, who I've always been a fan of. So we'll probably open some more of that stuff. As I said, I'm going to put a pack of that in the dorking box for Dorking with Dice the next time we do that, and I might mail out some of those packs to you guys so you can experience the joy of having one of these 3D cards. It's pretty neat. I mean, I've never really seen a card quite like that, do that before. So it is kind of cool. And this one also came in that lot that I opened yesterday, is one else I had never seen. And those are pretty neat too. If anything, I think these are even more complicated because they have some sort of a slidey mechanism there that allows them to go up and down like that. That's pretty neat stuff. So the other thing that I'm going to open today, I was in the in the Walgreens this morning. Had to pick up some things there, and they didn't have very many cards at all. I can tell you that. They had some Yu-Gi-Oh, and then they had some of this product, which we refer to, at least I refer to, as from the Fairfield Empire. The Fairfield Empire makes these. I believe that they build all of the structures around their estate out of trading cards, and whenever they need to restock the pharmacies around the country, they just, you know, take chunks out of certain rooms or certain towers, maybe. I'm not sure what other things they have there that they've built trading cards from. But anyway, they put the trading cards in these boxes and they send them out to people. I haven't opened a lot of football on the channel lately, so I thought, let's go ahead and spend $5 on one of these boxes and see what we get. It's 1 in 4 may contain a hit, and hopefully we'll get one of those out of here. We'll see just what we get. I think the best way to open these generally for me is the bottom. So, you know, we'll just get our paws in there and see what we get. I saw, I think it was Center Hill Cards. I have a sticker right over here, Center Hill Cards. He's tucked behind Trey Mancini for some reason. But I think it was Kevin over at Center Hill Cards was opening one of these just the other night. And he got some good cards out of it, but the pack he got out of it was a Notre Dame football pack of cards, which I had never seen before, and he was not excited about. And, you know, if that's what I get out of this, I'm also not going to be particularly excited about it, but we'll see just what is in here. No, instead we get a CFL pack. I've also seen the Canadian Football League packs come out of these as well recently, and I'm also a little nonplussed about that. One pack of cards and then a stack of all kinds of off-brand cards are likely to be here. We'll go through the stack second. Most people open the pack last, but I'm going to open the pack first, because I have no interest in the CFL. No offense to my Canadian viewers. It's just I'm kind of really into the NFL, but I really don't follow the CFL at all, and I probably will not recognize most of these players. So let's see what we got out of this CFL pack. Pretty cards, I'll give them that. Pacific apparently makes these, and they are, if I can get them in focus, they're really nice cards. My battery is now blinking, so I'm probably going to lose battery here. Reggie Hunt and Damon Allen and Damien Craig and Demetrius Maxey. I don't recognize those guys at all. So let's go through this stack before my battery runs out. And Charlie Ward, don't recognize him. Dustin Crum. Oh, we are really pulling the big name players today. Cyrus Habibi Lekio, Isaiah Spiller, Charleston Rambo, Kyron Williams, Arnold. I'm going to just stop reading these names because I don't even recognize any of these guys, literally. And I know a lot about football. And then we get some old scorecards. Carl Mecklenburg, he was a good linebacker for the Broncos for many years. Jim Everett, good quarterback. Mickey Schuler. What is this? Cameron Cleland, I don't recognize him. Aaron Murray. And Josh Freeman, he was a quarterback at the Buccaneers before Brady went there. And Lewis Oliver. And that is Torrey Holt, good wide receiver for many years. Daryl Thompson. Andre Ware. Got a really thick card in the back here. Eric Metcalf there. A couple of thick cards. These are the action-packed cards from back then. Ernest Givens and Ken Harvey. Okay, so that was really kind of a waste of $5. But I didn't know that at the time, and I thought, why not? All right, so there you go. That is the variety show today. Not as long as they usually are, but I hope just as enjoyable. Hope you guys are having a great Friday and looking forward to the weekend. I will try to get a video up this weekend. I don't know how it's going to be with the yard sale tomorrow, but I'll do the best I can, and I will see you guys then. As always, happy collecting.